Hi, kapamilya! I'm TJ Manato with some of the day's biggest headlines from BA.
Close to 10,000 people were left without power as intense winds and heavy rain from Tropical Storm Nestor battered parts of central and eastern Florida over the weekend. A tornado that touched down east of Tampa also severely damaged a school and overturned vehicles, including an 18-wheeler, causing traffic to back up for hours. Despite the tropical storm being short-lived, it brought about flash flood warnings to various areas. So far, there were no reports of storm-related injuries. Frank Abad owns over 80 rental units in Pensacola, Florida. He's thankful all of his properties were spared from the tropical storm.
If it's real hurricane, and if it is like Hurricane 1 or 2, that's where I'm worried about.
Okay.
But tropical storm, I'm not, because the building that we have can withstand the wind 140 miles.
Meanwhile, Romel Atoy said he encountered four major accidents on the road.
Ang lakas ng hangin, lakas din ang ulan. At basically, may mga part, thankfully, you know, I thank God that hindi naman wala na yung mga bata. But when I was going back home to the compound, doon ko na-encounter yung accidents niya. At I have to reroute myself. Okay, if you will go straight, definitely you will be stuck in traffic. So it's basically an inconvenience as well.
Atoy added that he made sure he and his family were prepared for the tropical storm.
Basically, as a family, we get some, not only some, but as much as we can, water, food, batteries, you know. And then we get a lot of fuel.
Moving on to sports, more than 7,000 miles from home, four young women of the Philippine gymnastics team are training hard in the U.S. as they prepare for the 2019 Southeast Asian Games to be held in the Philippines from November 30 to December 11. 24-year-old Dina Onofre, 18-year-old Iana Hermoso, 17-year-old Chloe Gatlabayan, and 16-year-old Maya Avery Wilson have been in California and Texas for about a month now.
There's a lot of gymnastics in Texas that are high caliber, and plus we have the equipment and the support, and therapy also plays a big part in it.
Just the atmosphere that really gives focus on developing progressional skills and everything they need. From the time that the girls have arrived in Texas until now, they've made such big improvements.
As team captain, Tina Onofre said their exposure in the U.S. has helped them a lot.
Maganda po kasi dito kami nagte-training sa US. Yung opportunities na binibigay ng mga coaches dito is talagang kakaiba at talagang supportive sila sa amin.
With the recent gold medal win of Carlos Yulo, the team gushed with pride but also admitted the added pressure is there.
It's inspiring and we're very proud of him and we're in awe. Yes, it puts pressure because we are the host country and we want to do well.
Inspired kami na maging katulad niya, magbigay ng karangalan para sa bansa.
The team will wrap up training in Texas by mid-November before flying back to Manila for the SEA Games.
We're keeping you connected to news that matters most, so be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm EJ Manato. We'll see you again later today with another BA Newsbreak.
This Balitang America Newsbreak is brought to you by Zoom.com and by Guerrero Yee LLP.